Hi everyone, Stephen Lee here. It's been a while. I hope you're well and you filed your 2020 tax return on time. In this video, I'll be discussing updates in regards to the new child tax credit that will be coming out and answering the following questions. Number one is, how is this credit different than the previous credit? Number two is, who will be eligible? Number three is, when will the payments begin and how much will they be? And number four is, what should you do to prepare for this credit? As normal, I'll leave a link in the information section below to the source of all this information that I'm presenting to you today. The two main sources are from the IRS website, so directly from the IRS. So let's get started. Number one is, how is this child tax credit different than the previous child tax credit? There have been many important changes, once again, to the child tax credit through the American Rescue Plan Act of 2021, and it expands it for only the 2021 year so far. Okay, so the credit that we're talking about in this video is only for the 2021 year so far. There have been talks that Biden and the administration is trying to push for the credit to be expanded to future years apart from 2021, but as of today, this credit is only related to the 2021 year. The expanded credit means four additional things. First off, the credit amounts will increase for many taxpayers. It's just because that the credit amount actually went up, okay, per child, as well as other eligibility requirements. The second is that the credit for qualifying children is fully refundable, okay, which means that taxpayers can benefit from the credit even if you do not have any earned income, which was a prereq for the previous child tax credit, or don't owe any income taxes. Okay, so this new credit is fully refundable. The third is, the credit will include children who turn age 17 in 2021. The previous credit, your child was only eligible under the age of 17. Okay. And fourthly, taxpayers may receive half of their credit in the form of an advance payment in 2021 before filing their 2021 income tax return. Remember, previously, if you wanted to claim the child tax credit, you were only eligible to claim it when you filed your annual tax return. This new child tax credit provides an advance payment, which I'm going to go into more detail later on in this video, in regards to receiving up to half of that credit in 2021, and then the remaining half when you file your 2021 tax return next year before April 15th. Okay. Remember, and then also under prior law, the child tax credit was up to $2,000 per qualifying child under the age of 17 by the end of the year. All right. While this credit, the big difference here is it's either going to be up to $3,000 per child based on age, or up to $3,600 per child based on age once again. Remember, if this is the kind of content that you're looking for, don't forget to hit subscribe, turn on your notifications, as I'll continue to update you and post videos related to this credit and other credits you may be eligible for. So let's go right into question number two. Who is eligible? And eligibility is going to be based on your filing status and your income. The income in this case and many other credits and benefits is called adjusted gross income, also known as AGI. That is what we're talking about when we talk about income qualifiers here. Okay, the increased amounts are reduced or phased out based on filing status. Okay, and I'm gonna give you what that phase out, where it begins based on your filing status. Okay, so for married taxpayers who are filing a joint return and qualifying widows and widowers, if your AGI is $150,000 and below, okay, you qualify 100% of this child tax credit. Okay. If your AGI is above $150,000, then it's gonna slowly phase out, okay? For those of you who file as head of household, the phase out will begin at $112,500. So if your AGI is under or equal to or under $112,500 and you file as head of household, then you qualify for 100% of the child tax credit. And for all other taxpayers, okay, all other tax filing statuses, it's gotta be, the phase out will begin at $75,000 above, okay? Okay, so if you are filing as a married filing separately or single and you have some qualifying children, then if your AGI is $75,000 and below, you'll qualify for 100% of the new child tax credit. Question number three is, when will the payments begin and how much will they be for? Advance payments of the 2021 child tax credit are scheduled to start July 15th. Okay, once again, the IRS has announced that the advance payment, remember there's two parts to this credit potentially. You can receive half of it in 2021 and claim the other half when you file your 2021 tax return. The advance payment is set to begin on July 15th. And in the link in the information section below, one of them, the second one, you'll see that the IRS has already announced that they plan to begin to send out payments starting July 15th, 2021. The total of the advance payments will be up to, once again, 50% or half of the child tax credit, which equates to basically up to $300 per month per child under the age of six. Okay, so that's up to $300 per month per child under the age of six. And for children ages 6 to 17, okay, it's up to $250 per month per child. Okay, so that's between ages 6 to 17, up to $250 per month per child. Remember, these advance payments is only going to be for 6 months, July through December 2021. Okay, so potentially if you have a child that's under the age of six and you qualify for 100% based on your income, then $300 times six, you may receive up to $1,800 or $1,800 for that child in 2021 in the form of an advance payment. Remember, advance payments are going to be based on information included on your 2020 tax returns, which have been filed. Okay, but if you have not yet filed your 2020 tax return, the qualification is going to be based on your 2019 tax return. Okay, and then until your 2020 return is processed. The IRS has also mentioned that these advance payments are planned to be paid out on the 15th of every month, okay, starting from July 15th through December 15th. Okay, so the 15th of every month is when the IRS plans to make these payments to you. Kiplinger's has a great 2021 child tax credit calculator, and I'll leave a link in the information section below. So you can click on that link, take a look to see how much you actually qualify for or potentially qualify for this new child tax credit. I would love to hear your comments on this credit. Is it a good idea or a bad idea? Please post a comment below. Always be respectful and encouraging, but I would love to hear your thoughts on the comment. Once again, the IRS also urges people with children to file their 2020 tax returns as soon as possible to make sure that if you're eligible, that you would receive the appropriate child tax credit amount. Okay, because if you're going off of old data or 2019 return, you know, your income might have changed, the number of qualifying children may have changed, things like that. So the IRS urges people, get your 2020 tax return in as soon as possible. Okay, and once again, file electronically, not by paper, and include your direct deposit information so that you can get this new credit as soon as possible and as quickly as possible, starting July 15th. The last question is, what to do to prepare for this credit? Okay, what can you do? And this question really goes out to those whose filing status might have changed, income might have changed, the number of qualifying children might have changed, you might have had a baby in 2021 that the IRS might not be aware of just yet. What do you need to do? Once again, the IRS tells us that eligible taxpayers do not need to take any action just yet apart from filing their 2020 tax return if you have not done so. So that is priority number one, is file your 2020 tax return as soon as possible. Eligible taxpayers who do not want to receive an advance payment, okay, so there's many of you out there who want to opt out of receiving an advance payment just because you know that your income, your qualifiers have changed for 2021 versus your 2020 return, and you want to opt out from that advance payment, or you want to receive that advance payment, or you want to receive the credit in one lump sum when you file your 2021 tax return, you will be able to decline the advance payment through an IRS portal that has not yet been released, but it should be coming over the next few weeks. You know, the IRS mentioned in their notice that this portal should be available starting at least at the latest by July 1st, so at least 2 weeks before the advance payments are set to be sent out. So keep by, make sure you subscribe to this channel. I'll let you know once that portal is up and ready so you can opt out. Also, once again, taxpayers will have the opportunity to update their information for changes in their income, their filing status, as well as the number of qualifying children that you have in 2021. Okay. More details on how to take these steps will be announced soon by the IRS, and I'll definitely keep you posted, so turn on those notifications. Thank you for watching. Until next time, I wish you all a wonderful day. Bye.